This is a MyDia Mini Split Air Conditioner motherboard. It is also used in many other air conditioning brands. It has a serial communication problem. When I attach the indoor and outdoor, it shows an E1 error, which is a communication problem. The communication problem could be in the indoor motherboard too. But most of the time, I have experienced that when the outdoor motherboard goes bad, then it causes this problem in the mini split AC. When the motherboard is completely dead and does not turn on at all, it is obvious that indoor and outdoor will not communicate with one another. The most common issue is when the fuse or any other component in the motherboard goes bad. Now I have passed electricity through this motherboard. In our case, the motherboard is turning on but not communicating with the indoor motherboard. The LED light in the motherboard board has started to blink. I connected the wires with the line and neutral in the connector and then passed electricity through it.
On the S, I will check the signals.
I will place the multimeter's black probe on the neutral and red on the S to check the voltages. The multimeter is passing a few millivolts, which are fluctuating. And these communication voltages are not fine. We should get stable voltages without the indoor being attached to it. This could have helped us to repair this motherboard easily. I have another outdoor motherboard. The communication circuit of this motherboard is absolutely fine. So let me show you the proper voltages on the communication terminals without the indoor unit being attached to it. Let me pass electricity through it. I have placed the probes on the same neutral and signal terminal. I am checking the DC voltages. 4.44 volts are passing through these terminals. Now I will put the multimeter on AC volts. It shows almost the same voltage as AC, which is 4.82 volts. If these much volts pass through the motherboard's main terminal, then the motherboard communication circuit will be considered good. I have turned on the indoor unit. I will check the communication on its electric terminal too, without attaching the outdoor unit. I have attached black probe with the neutral and red probes with the signal wire. I am checking the DC voltages. The DC voltages fluctuate. And the multimeter is showing the voltages in negative. And these voltages are fine. It will be considered good if the indoor motherboard shows this much voltage on the communication terminals without the outdoor attached. I have set the multimeter to AC voltages. I have attached the probes back to the same terminals. The voltages are fluctuating. The indoor motherboard communication will be considered good if voltages are shown on the multimeter. This means the problem could be in the outdoor motherboard. To fix the communication problem, I will check the communication circuit on the motherboard. This is the communication circuit in this motherboard. I will check the communication through the oscilloscope or DSO. We can't check its signals without it. The outdoor motherboard has turned on. I have attached the indoor and outdoor motherboards together. The indoor is working at 17 degrees. I will first check the optocoupler on the right side. Left pin is the anode, and the right side is the cathode. I place the probe of the oscilloscope with the anode pin to check whether signals are passing through the optocoupler or not. Almost 160 volts of signals are generated in the optocoupler. The other pin also should have the same. It also has the same volts. Now let's check the pin of the output voltages from the emitter to the collector. This is the emitter, and the fourth number pin is the collector. Let's check whether the voltages are generated here or not. No voltages are here on this pin of the output. Now I am checking the voltages on the emitter pin. 5 volts are passing on this pin. Now I will check this second optocoupler. This optocoupler takes the signals towards the indoor unit. This pin is the anode, and the other pin is the cathode. First, I am checking on the anode. Only 5 voltages are generated on this pin. This means no signals are generated here. Now the next pin. 5 volts are also generated on this pin too. Now I am checking the collector pin of the second optocoupler. 5 signals on this pin is not correct, which is minus 5 volts. These volts are nothing. Now I will check the signals on the emitter. ₹160 signals are generated on this pin. So now I have to decide what thing is faulty in this communication circuit. I have checked all these resistors and diodes, they are absolutely fine. So these optocouplers could be bad in this communication circuit. The left optocoupler is bad because high voltages pass through this optocoupler. And the optocoupler on the right side receives the signal from the indoor unit to the outdoor. It has less chance of getting bad as it passes low voltages. The optocoupler I have removed is 851. This is the new optocoupler. I am installing the same number. Because as we sometimes think that if I install another number optocoupler, it might work. But it does not work. Now let's check how many voltages we get on the collector pins. The signals have now changed. The signals are now fluctuating. 140 volts are passing through its collector. Now let's check its input, which is coming from the microcontroller. I will press the auto button on the oscilloscope. The input from the microcontroller to the optocoupler input is fine now. Signals are generated on the oscilloscope screen. Let's check the other optocoupler also. The voltages and the signals are now generated fine over here too. You can see the pulses moving on the oscilloscope screen. This means this motherboard has been fixed. Click on the left or right thumbnail to watch our next videos. And subscribe. Thank you.